Hello class 10 children. Now as you all know, we are doing database management system unit. That is your unit of part B in information technology. Now I have already told you about how to create a database, then how to create a table in a database and insert values in that table. Now we had made a table student with the following fields, that was roll number, class, date of birth and marks. There were three rows in the table and we had already inserted the three values in this table. Now I told you that in database we can retrieve or get the data from the table. This table is stored in the database. Now first thing is, if you want to select any row or record from this table, suppose first I want to select the second row from the table. So I will just write the select query as select, then an asterisk mark, from student where roll number is equals to 2 and then a semicolon. Now here asterisk refers to that we are referring to all the data of the table. That is why we have used the sign asterisk. And the table name, it has to be in the same case as it was there. Then roll number, it has to be in the same case as that was mentioned in the table. That means R was capital and N was capital. And since we wanted the data of roll number 2, so we wrote the query as select star from student where roll number is equals to 2. Do not forget to put a semicolon. After that we will press enter, and what you will find is the answer of the query will be only the record of roll number 2 will be visible to you. Suppose we want to show the entire table, so we will just write select asterisk from student and then a semicolon, press enter, we will find the entire table in front of us. So in the similar way, whichever roll number we want, I have just showed you about three roll numbers. Suppose there are 50 students in a class and you entered the data for 50 students using the insert query. You want to show the data of roll number 48. So instead of searching, you will just write the query select star from student where roll number is equals to 48 and then a semicolon. So this will help you to get the data of roll number 48. Now this is about the select query. Now next is your arranging something or ordering something in the database. Now suppose in this database we have given in this table the fourth column, that is marks. We want to arrange the marks in a particular order. So there are two orders, ascending or descending. Ascending means arranging from lowest to highest marks, and descending means arranging from highest to lowest marks. So if we want to execute the query for this, we will write select asterisk from student order by marks ASC and then a semicolon. Here order by refers to that we are ordering the marks in a particular way, ascending or descending. ASC stands for ascending. Remember children, there is no space in between order and by. So just write select star from student order by marks ASC and then a semicolon. You press enter, what you will find is marks are arranged in ascending order. In this table, ascending will be from the roll number 2 marks will be at the top, that is 75. Roll number 1 marks will be beneath it, that is 80. And lastly, you will get roll number 3 marks, that is 90. All other fields of the table will also be present. That means you will find roll number, class, date of birth, marks, all the four columns. Just marks you will find arranged in ascending order. Similarly, if you want to arrange the marks in descending order, so you will write select star from student order by marks DESC in case you want to arrange the marks from highest to the lowest. Semicolon, press enter, you will find the entire data. Since why we are using this asterisk sign, because you want to display the entire data of the table. So select star from student order by marks DESC. So you will find all the columns of the table. In addition, you will find that marks column has been arranged in descending. That means roll number 3 marks will be at the top, followed by roll number 1 and then by roll number 2. So today we have studied about two queries. One is your select query and the other one is your select and then using an order by. Apart from select, there are many other queries that can be executed. We can update the marks of any child. We can update the date of birth of any child. Then we can insert a new record in this table. We can add a new column in this table. So all these we will be studying step by step. So today you have studied two queries. One is your select query for selection of data from the table and other one is select using the order by command. So children, you have to make notes from the video itself and make this table also. Plus where you are writing select star from student where roll number is 2, beneath it, this query, you will write the answer of the query also. That is, when you execute this query, select star from student where roll number is 2, you will just draw one row of the table with roll number 2. I have not shown you in this video the answer, but you will draw it. Then select star from student, you will make the entire table the answer of the query. Similarly, select star from student order by marks ASC, you will be drawing this table with the marks arranged in ascending order. And lastly, the marks arranged in descending order. That means after every query, you will be writing the answer also. So that is all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.